In this video, I explain how to draw PV, TS and HS diagram of the Rankine cycles by using this animation of PV, TS and HS diagram, so you will understand it easily. So you already know in a Rankine cycle there is a four component are there. First one is the boiler, turbine, condenser and pump. So first we understand the which process is carried out in the boiler. So in the boiler, that is a isobaric heat supply process is carried out, means at the constant pressure heat is supplied to the water and water is converted into the steam. Isobaric means at the constant pressure. Okay, so this 1 to 2 process is the isobaric heat supply process, and during this process water is converted into steam. So first we understand the PV diagram. What is the P? P means pressure and V means volume. In this PV diagram, that is a one curve is there, and this curve is called as the saturation curve. And in this saturation curve, this point is called as the critical point. Okay. And this saturation curve, left side from this critical point, means this side, it is called as the saturated liquid line. Means in this line, suppose we put in this point, then it's the liquid is indicated. And this region is called as the liquid region. Same way, right side from this critical point, means this line, is called as the saturated vapor line, and this region is called as the vapor region. Means in this line or in this region, we putting any point, it indicate the vapor. And area under this saturated curve is indicate the wet region. Wet region means here the mixing of liquid and vapor are there, means here the mixture of water plus steam is there. Okay, so point number one is coming at that which side. So we know that at the inlet of the boiler there is a water state is there, means point number one is coming this line or the left side to these lines. Okay, now pressure at the inlet of the boiler is high because the water is coming from the pump, and in the pump the pressure is increased. Okay, so we are putting point number one somewhere here. Okay, and this is the liquid region. And why we draw the horizontal line? We draw horizontal line because pressure remains constant. Okay, and in the boiler what happened? Water is converted into the steam. So here you see this, the line is moving towards the steam side. Okay, this is the liquid, this is the mix regions, and this is the vapor region. So at the outlet of the boiler, there is three possibilities are there. Okay, means there are three types of the steam. First one is the wet steam, second one is the dry unsaturated, and third one is the superheated. Means, suppose the wet steam is coming out from the boiler, then this 2 point is coming in this region. Okay, so here we putting this is a 2 dash. This is a 2 point, means suppose dry and saturated steam are coming. Dry and saturated means the steam are completely dry, means no water particles are there. And the wet steam means there is a mixture of water and steam. Okay, so mixture of water and steam is coming, then the point number 2 is coming from the left side to this vapor, saturated vapor line. Dry and saturated means they come on this side, and this is called as the superheated, means these 2 dash is indicate the superheated regions. Okay. Now next we draw the other diagram, that is the TS diagrams. Okay. T means temperature, that is on the Y axis. On the X axis entropy is there. Same way as the PV diagram, here one saturation curve is there, means the shape of the curve is different, but it is called as the saturation curve. This is the critical point. Same thing, from the critical point, left side is indicate saturated liquid line, right side is indicate saturated vapor line, and this is the mixing region. Okay, so where this point number one is coming? So point number one, at the inlet of the boiler, temperature of the water is low. So when we heat it, its temperature is first increased. Okay, then it is convert to liquid to vapor, and then after it is the superheated. Okay, so point number one is coming this here at this bottom part. This is point number one. So first the temperature of the water is increased. So here you see this, suppose we take the projection of the point number one on the Y axis. So here we take the T1, and here is coming the some T1 dash points. Okay, then after this water start to convert into the steam. Okay, so initially the water is not directly converted into the steam. Suppose there is a first 5% of the water is converted into the steam, then after they are converted to 10%, 20%, 50%, and finally it's converted into the completely steam. So here they are completely converted into the steam. Okay, and then after, suppose we supply more heat to the steam, then it is converted into the superheated steam. So here today's point is indicate the wet region. Means suppose the mixed steams are coming, water plus steam are coming, then the point number 2 is present here. Suppose the steam is dry and saturated, then we putting this point number 2 here. And suppose the steam is superheated, then we putting this point here somewhere, that is a 2 double dash. Okay. So suppose we take this projection of the 2 dash and 2, we get the same points here. Okay, that is the same temperatures. One where what is the meaning of superheated steam? Means temperature of the steam is higher than the boiling points of the water at the particular pressure. Okay. So here is temperature of the steam is increased. Okay. So this cross line is indicate first temperature of the water is increased. Means here sensible heat is transferred. In this part, latent heat is transferred, means water is converted into the steam. And here at the point 2, steam is available and this steam temperature is increased. So we draw this cross line and it is called as the sensible heat transfer. Now we draw the third diagram, HS, that is the enthalpy. Enthalpy is denoted as the H on the y axis. On the x axis, entropy is there. In this HS diagram, same way this curve line is there. This is called as the saturation curve. And in this HS diagram, the constant pressure line is drawn like this curve line. Okay, so this curve line is indicate the constant pressure line. Okay, so where is this point number 1 is come? Point number 1 is come on this liquid region. So here we putting point number 1. We are also putting point number 1 on these lines. Okay, it is depending on these conditions. Then this side, this water is convert into this liquid plus steams, and here this water is completely convert into the dry and saturated steam. So here this 2 dash point is in this wet region. This is on the saturation curve and this is the superheated region. It is a 2 double dash. Now then after, this steam is supplied to this turbine. Okay, so here 3 types of the steam is possible, because on this all the 3 diagram we indicate that is a 3 points. Okay, 2 dash, 2 and 2 double dash. 2 dash is indicate the wet, point 2 is indicate dry and saturated, and 2 double dash is indicate the superheated. Okay, so this steam is supplied into the turbine, and in the turbine process 2 to 3 is carried out, and the name of the process is isentropic expansion process. So in the turbine, isentropic expansion process is carried out. What is the meaning of isentropic? Isentropic means entropy remains constant, means entropy at the point 2 and entropy at the point 3 are same, means S2 is equal to S3. So on this x axis, here you see in this 2 diagram entropy are there. Okay, so how we draw this line? Suppose entropy is remains constant, means S2 and S3 are same. Okay, so we need to draw this vertical line. Okay, but from this point number 2, we have a 2 option. Either we draw the vertical line in upper directions or vertical line in this downward directions. Okay, and the second thing, when the expansion is carried out, its pressure is reduced. Pressure is reduced means the some pressure is utilized to produce some work, means this turbine is produce some mechanical work. Okay, that's why this pressure of the steam is reduced. So first we draw this PV diagram. Okay, so pressure is reduced, then what happened? From this point number 2, point number 3 is coming in this lower side, because the pressure is reduced. Okay, at this point value of the pressure is 0, when we moving upper direction value of the pressure is increased. Okay, and what's the change in the volume? Volume is also increased because it is the expansion. So when the expansion is done, the volume is increased. Okay, so we draw these types of the line, that is a curve line. Here you see this pressure is reduced from the P2 dash to 3 dash, and this volume is increased. Here you see this is itself some V2 dash volume and here V3 dash. So on the x axis, when we moving right sides, the whatever the parameter, it is the increase. Okay, suppose we consider it is a dry and saturated steam, so we draw these types of the line. Suppose we consider at the inlet of the turbine it is a superheated steam, then we draw these types of the line. It is a 3 dash. Okay, now in this HS and the TS diagram, we draw the vertical line because the entropy is remains constant, means from this 2 dash point we draw this line. Okay, that is a 2 dash and 3 dash. So suppose we take this projection of the 2 dash and 3 dash point on this x axis, means on the entropy, then we get 1 point. So when we get 1 point, what is meaning? S2 dash is equal to S3 dash. So Suppose we consider at the inlet of the turbine, the steam is dry and saturated, means from this 2 point we draw one downward line. Okay, so again we take projection, we take the 1 point, it is S2 is equal to S3. And for the superheated, we draw same time downwards line. Okay. On the HS diagram, same thing we follow. This pressure is reduced up to this condenser pressure. Okay, so this line is indicate the constant pressure at the condenser. So we draw again vertical line in a downward directions. Okay, and we get the only 1 point on the x-axis, S2 dash is equal to S3 dash. That means the entropy is remains constant. Okay. Now then after, the steam coming out from the turbine is supplied to these condensers. Okay. So this condenser is a one type of heat exchanger. Okay. But this heat exchanger name is given condenser because in this heat exchanger, condensation process is carried out. Now what is the meaning of condensation? Condensation means steam is converted into the water. Okay. And in heat exchanger, the every process is carried out at the constant pressure. So you are studying in any subject, we are considered in a heat exchanger, constant pressure process is carried out. Okay. So in actual pressure is not constant, there is some friction losses are there. Okay. Now, so in a condenser, the process is constant pressure heat rejection. Okay. So first thing is the constant pressure, means from the point number 3 on the PV diagram, at least we know that we need to draw horizontal line. Okay. So from the point number 3, we have the two options. Either we draw the horizontal line in a left direction or a left side or a right side. Okay. So we know that in the condenser, the steam is converted into the water. So by default, we need to draw in the left side because this side is for the liquid sides and the water is liquids. Okay. So we draw this type of the line. Okay. So here you see this point number 4 is come on this liquid line. Okay. Same way on the TS diagram, we draw the horizontal lines. So here we consider in the condenser there is a latent heat transfer out there. Means at the constant temperature, the steam is converted into the water. Its temperature are not changed. That's why we draw this horizontal line. And this point number 4 is again come to this saturated liquid line. Now we take the projection of the point 3 and the point 4 on the y-axis. We get only 1 point. T3 is equal to T4. Okay. Means here temperature are same, but the steam is converted into the water, it's called as the latent heat transfer. Okay. And again, on for the HS diagram, we know that it is a constant pressure process. So point number 4 is also coming this line, this curve line. Okay. So here we putting this point number 4 and it is come into this liquid line. Okay. Then after, it is supplied to this pump, means here we need to draw the close the our circuit. In the pump, the pressure is increased. Okay. So here we draw means just we not need to think much, just we need to close the diagram, means we need to close point number 4 and 1. And in this pump we supply some mechanical work and this work is WP. Okay, so we draw in vertical line. Why we draw vertical? Because in a pump the volume of the water is not changed and its pressure is increased. So we take this projection of the point 1 and 4 on the x-axis, we get only 1 point, that is V1 is equal to V4. Okay. And the pressure is increased from the P4 to P1. Same way on the TS diagram, its slight temperature is increased due to the frictions in the pump. Okay. And we take the projection of this 1 and 4, it is come as the isentropic process here. Okay. Same way on this HS diagram, we draw the vertical line, we close it. We take the projection on the x-axis, we get the 1 point, it is S1 is equal to S4. And its slight enthalpy is increased. Why enthalpy is increased? Because there is a change in temperatures. Because the H is equal to Cp into delta T, means temperature is increased then enthalpy is increased, temperature is reduced then enthalpy is decreased. So here I complete this PV, TS and HS diagram of the Rankine cycle. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to power plant engineering, engineering thermodynamics. Okay, for the power plant engineering, link is provided in the descriptions as well as in car. For thermodynamics or other subject of these mechanical engineering, I request to visit the playlist and don't forget to share this video with your friend.